2016 is said to be a transformative year for Ergomed. The company posted an update on its current co-development partnerships and said it is on track to deliver important clinical data next year. Let's discuss it with the Chief Business Officer of the company, Andrew Mackie. Now, Andrew, thank you for joining us today. Andrew, all four of your active partnerships have studies in late-stage development, but two are set to deliver final results in 2016, and one of them is your partnership with Eterna's and Taris for Zoptrex. It's a potential treatment for female endometrial cancer.
Of course. So Eterna's and Taris study has completed recruitment this year. We announced that back in October, and as you know, how trials work is that you treat the patients, but then you follow the patients up for a period of time just to make sure that you're observing the true treatment effect. So we're now in the follow-up phase with this trial. So what we're waiting for is a sufficient number of outcomes to happen, and then the company will complete the analysis, and we should find out what the results say sometime during 2016. The study's in late-stage research, so it's a phase 3 study. And if this study is successful, then that should open the door to allow the company to launch the product probably the following year or early in the year after.
And what about the size of the market you're targeting with this treatment?
Well, it's for endometrial cancer, which is not one of the big tumor types. Those would be lung cancer, breast cancer, but it has a significant market share. I think our analysts are forecasting sales in this sort of mid half billion range, and the company has forecast sales in around that size as well. So it's slightly below blockbuster, but it's very difficult to tell how these products succeed. You know, once you get your first indication, often you can try and actually look for a second indication, which would open up the market. But it will be a very significant driver if it's successful.
And some potentially good news for insomnia sufferers as well. So tell us about loredipnon. I believe there are already drugs out there treating insomnia. So what's different about it?
Absolutely. So most of the drugs on the market at the moment have a duration of effect of about 4 hours. So you take the pill, it helps you go to sleep. But because most of us like to sleep 7-8 hours, the treatment effect wears off in the middle of the night, and often you'll wake up. And a large proportion of patients who suffer from insomnia have this effect, so that the current therapies don't keep them asleep all night long. What Ferrer have done is they've manipulated the chemistry around some of the existing molecules out there to allow the body to metabolize the drug a little bit more slowly, and therefore you have a longer duration of effect, so you stay asleep throughout the night, or this is what they're hoping will happen. But the important thing is that the drug metabolism completes its cycle by the 8 hours. So you don't have this tail off or hangover effect in the morning. So it reaches similar plasma levels as the other drugs in the market. So what we're doing now, the company has conducted a phase 1 study with the product already and has seen this profile. What we're doing at the moment with them in partnership is we're running a phase 2 study to confirm the PK or the pharmacokinetic profile, which is how the body metabolizes the drug. But we're also now studying very closely what the clinical effects of the drug are, so how well it keeps patients asleep throughout the night. Then if this phase 2A study is successful, then it will go into a later stage trial, a phase 3 trial, where, again, the partners will confirm the treatment effect and complete the research to take into market.
Elsewhere, Andrew, I'd like you to tell me about the study for Multikine, your potential treatment for head and neck cancer.
So this is a therapy which is a combination of proteins, that some of which are found in the body naturally, and this combination of proteins is meant to stimulate the immune system. And what researchers have found in the last decade or so is the immune system is very intricately involved in how cancer is handled by the body. And so by bolstering the immune system, what we're hoping is that this treatment will help the body fight the cancer itself. So we're at the moment running what we believe is the largest head and neck cancer study in the world. It's taking place in over 80 centers, and we're looking to recruit 880 patients in total. The recruitment's going very well. It's a very challenging study because the patients are quite ill. The therapy needs to be given in coordination with other treatments, so with their patient's radiotherapy, in certain sort of conditions within the hospital. So you have to work hard to find the patients, but we're well underway of completing the recruitment, which we'll hope to complete the recruitment next year.
And finally, can you tell us about your partnership with De La Ferrette, the Swedish biotech?
Indeed. I mean, this is a good example of the different types of partners we have. So Eternus Antares, as we talked about, is sort of a mid-sized public biotech company, Ferrer being a large-ish mid-sized European pharma company. De La Ferrette is a spin-out from the Karolinska Institute. It's a classic biotech company, VC-backed, and they've taken heparin, which is a known molecule, and they've made some adjustments to the chemistry of the heparin to use it as a drug to treat a complication called vascular occlusive disorder in patients with sickle cell anemia. And one of the reasons why Ergomed was keen to get involved in this partnership is with our presence in the Middle East and with the disease presenting itself quite strongly in the Middle East, we were well positioned really to run this trial and find the patients.
Okay.
So the study started. We announced in the summer the recruitment has started. And again, we hope to make good progress in this study and help the company advance the program as much as possible.
So to sum up, Andrew, 2016 is set to be a year of significant change for the company and key milestones to be achieved.
Absolutely. I mean, what we found is an increasing amount of interest in the company's business model. So we have the revenue-generating service side of the company, and then we have this shared risk side. The shared risk can provide significant returns if the products are successful. So we have a couple of chances on that going forward. But equally, we hope to sign new partnerships to sort of build the co-development portfolio. And what this shows is when these succeed, we get a tremendous upside. But the company is very solid, and whether these co-development relationships succeed or not, the company is strong and continues generating revenues and continues going forward.
And next year, you will also be targeting further partnerships. So I'd like to know what you consider when you're looking at new partners.
Well, we have a focus in a number of therapeutic areas. So principally, we're looking for compounds in the rare disease space, in oncology and neurology. We're looking for partners who want to continue to be involved in their program. So we're not at the moment looking simply to in-license molecules. We're looking for partners that we can help advance their molecules going forward. And then we look at the standard things which all people in the biotech and pharma industry would look at. So we look at how strong the IP is, so that when you get to market, you have a secure place. We look at the competitive advantage the molecule will have. So if it does get to market, will it be better than the existing treatments? And is there a place for this molecule in the market? And then thirdly, we look at market size as well. So we're, you know, even in the rare disease space, you need to make sure that there's a significant amount of potential commercially for the product. And so we need to believe that with the treatment benefit it can confer, that the product has a commercial viability as well. So those are our three principal areas that we focus on in the initial screening. And then once we get further into due diligence, obviously we look very closely at the preclinical data and if they have any clinical data that's been generated, just to make sure we believe in the mechanism of action, that we believe in the data signals that have been generated to date, so that when we do start making our investment, we have confidence in the drug.
Okay, Andrew, thank you very much for your time today.
My pleasure. Nice to speak to you.
Andrew Mackie, Chief Business Officer at Ergomed.